something competition I did in about 5 years back. As next, we have a very beautiful surprise. In the late 40s, there was an American composer named Lou Harrison. The composer Lou Harrison from America, he went to China in the late 40s.
这个作曲家，然后来自美国，然后他去大陆，然后呢产生一些经验，然后把它来做这个曲子，然后他是到中东这个地区，然后我们刚刚有介绍说一个很特别的乐器，它其实是来自印度尼西亚，我来请大家帮大家示范一下。
In China, he discovered the beautiful Chinese music with its very special instruments.
那个中国大陆有很多很多很漂亮、很美丽、很好听的声音的乐器。
He tried them out. He loved them, and he wrote a composition for this instrument, some kind of them. And a beautiful Western violin.
Good. 好，他现在要说的是说，他叙述的是一个对话，小提琴跟一个打击乐器的对话。
In those days, there were no planes, so they had to use the ship.
他们搭船，然后从大陆到美国。They
need a long time, and Lou Harrison forgot all the instruments he wanted to use.
他大老远去到中国，就是想要使用这些乐器。At
home, he tried to remember the sounds, but he didn't have the instruments, so he used self-made stuff.
但是他没办法，但是他就记下这个乐器的声音，所以他就用一些生活上的用品去处理。
So there is like the metal plates,
像是铁片。Like
the flower pots from Taiwan this time.
这其实是他们在那个深圳路上面去那个 home box 买的花盆。
Very beautiful instruments are just there. It's a simply tin boxes.
一些我们有时候打击乐器，台湾也会使用到的罐头，他们这个是买的比较好看的牛奶罐。And
still, he always wanted to play like a violin, but he was too tall for it, so he used the double bass.
他们那个要用那个声音，但是呢，实在没办法找到那个那样的乐器，所以他们使用敲打我们的 double bass， 就是钉大提琴。 其实它这有点像模仿古筝的声音。And
then finally he used two wash tubes.
他们常见的水桶。And
now we kindly welcome Ivan Huang, whom we thank very much. He made it possible that we can play here this night.
接下来这首曲子是打击乐器跟那个小提琴的对话。 那其实有点像是一对夫妻在吵架，那我们等一下来看到底是小提琴吵赢还是打击吵赢。来，我们欢迎Ivan教授，大家掌声欢迎。
Thank you.
谢谢大家，你们好。